We're kind of just focusing on grinding through, you know, whatever the weather gives us and just keeping the ball in play. And, you know, we're not really focusing on scores right now, as our end goal is to play our best at conference. So we just really want to keep the ball in play and get some good experience.
Yeah, talk about your last round, how challenging the weather conditions were. And when it's like that, how do you try to keep your head level and just focus on what you're talking about, keeping the ball in play and controlling the things you can?
Yeah, it's when the weather is like that, you know, miserable, it's kind of just all the mental aspect. You know, you want to give up, but then you just have to fight through it. And I think those who do fight through it are really the ones that kind of come out on top. But yeah, it's just, you know, one shot at a time, just slowing down. You know, everyone's in the same conditions, and so you just have to tell yourself that and just keep fighting through.
Talk a little about that in terms of how you've grown in the last 4 years in the program into a senior now. Is that a part of your game, your mental game, that you think has improved a lot?
Yeah, I think so. You know, I just kind of grind through whatever, you know, the day throws at you, and I think that just kind of comes with experience, and you know, you just kind of got to get used to whatever's handed to you. So.
And you guys have a veteran-heavy team on the women's side, a lot of players who have been in this program for multiple years. You're obviously the senior, the most upperclassmen, but what's that dynamic like leadership-wise to have a lot of experienced players?
You know, it's been great. You know, there's five of us who have been really close together for the last 3 years, and even over the last year, you know, adding some three new players, it's been great. I feel like they're all my best friends, you know, and we just have a lot of fun together, and our chemistry has really solidified over the last couple of years.
Aside from the mental game, which you talked about a little bit, are there any other areas of your game you're really going to look to focus on in this tournament and the next couple tournaments coming up this spring?
Yeah, I think I've kind of been struggling with putting a little bit myself, just because that's kind of, you know, something that you don't get to practice. You know, you get to simulate the full swings in the winter, but, you know, the short chips and putting is kind of the harder thing that kind of has to develop as we get outside again. And so that's going to kind of be my focus going forward. And then also just keeping the ball in play and, you know, just battling through whatever happens. So.
Yeah, I think they're really excited about it. None of these players have ever been to Walking Stick down in Pueblo. So they're excited about it. It's a good field. It's the best field that they've seen this year. So they're ready for it, and we're kind of getting to the point where, you know, they're getting familiar with how they should be preparing for a golf course, which is mostly around the greens. You know, they really need to spend time around the greens, get familiar with those specific greens. Tee to green is pretty similar no matter where you go. It'll be nice to play at a little higher elevation for them, which will be a little bit, you know, more of what they're used to rather than sea level. So yeah, I think they're excited about it, and luckily Pueblo didn't get as much snow as the rest of Colorado, so everything should be ready to go for them when they get there.
You have a great senior leader in Sydney Rochford, a four-year player in the program. Talk about what she brings to the table and how much you rely on her to help guide this team.
Yeah, just her work ethic. You know, she brings such a good work ethic and really takes it serious. The program means a lot to her. She's earned her stripes in this program, so to speak. You know, she's seen all sides of it. She's had to work her way and earn everything she's gotten from hard work. So, you know, and she's really starting to just own her game, take ownership of her game. And I feel like, you know, the other players, especially the young ones, that lead by example, you know, they feed off of that really well. So she does a great job of that.
What are some points of emphasis the team will focus on this week in their game? They had a frustrating outing last time, mostly due to the weather, just unbearable conditions almost they had to deal with. How do you kind of shake that off and kind of look forward, flip the page onto a new tournament this week?
Yeah, you know, they had, last event was tough. The weather was really tough. We were throwing everything, wind, rain, sun. It was cold, yeah, it was all of it. So, not to mention a tough golf course. You know, both of the golf courses they've played so far, you know, have been difficult. So, but just controlling what they can control, that's all that we can focus on. You know, we don't know what the weather might be like down in Pueblo. It could change on us while we're there. So, you know, just getting themselves ready to play, and, you know, we've said it all along, we're just trying to get better every day. So, you know, if we can get a little bit better, you know, our scores might not show it, you know, a ton, But if we can get a little bit better in all areas and every player can do that, then the team results will certainly show.